In this session, we are going to discuss about cholangioscopy, and I will be discussing about the basic equipment and the accessories and their application. So cholangioscopy has been relatively late to arrive on the horizon of GI endoscopy and very slow to evolve. This mainly happened because of the small diameter of the duct, and electronic equipments of that size were not available initially. However, as the science has progressed, now we have better equipment available, and now we have a relatively good system, better system available, which is can be used for in a variety of situations. We require cholangioscopy in a variety of situations like biliary system cancer, stone disease, mainly for fragmentation of pancreatic and biliary stone, then in primary sclerosing cholangitis, in the setting of strictures, whether this is benign or malignant, and then for the retrieval of migrated stents from the bile duct or pancreatic duct. We have dominantly three types of systems available. First system was mother baby scope system, where two operators were required. The baby scope used to be passed through the working channel of the ERCP scope. It had only two-way angulation. It was relatively fragile. And now we have a direct video cholangioscopy where ERCP and sphincterotomy is done, balloon dilatation is done, and then the ERCP scope is removed and a small diameter scope is passed through the cut papilla. So advantage of this system is that this has a narrowband imaging facility, but difficulty is that it is very difficult to pass this scope across a stricture and deep into the bile duct or pancreatic duct. Then we have a spy glass first generation, which is called legacy system. And then we have second and third generation, which is called a spyglass DS and DS2. So this is single operator's device. So I'm going to discuss a little more about it. So the legacy system, you used to have a spyglass probe, which was reusable. And then we had a spyglass catheter, which used to be single use. So this is how the legacy system looked like. There used to be a dedicated cart, which used to be a stand beside our standard ERCP cart. The video quality was suboptimal, but still it was good enough to do lithotripsy and the sampling from the bile duct or the pancreatic duct. But now we have a spyglass DS came in 2015, and then DS2 came in 2018. This is a totally new system, and this is a plug and play system, doesn't require assembly in the endoscopy suite. And video quality has improved, the passage of accessories has become easier. And now we have redesigned accessories, and this is a SpyBite Max biopsy forceps, which is a better forceps, and tissue sampling has improved with this forceps. And then we also have a snare and the basket available for compatible with this system. So steps involved in the cholangioscopy is basically we have to do ERCP, selective and pancreatic duct cannulation, and then we have to do a sphincterotomy, possibly balloon dilatation for easy passage of SPI scope. Then the SPI scope is advanced into the bile duct under direct visualization as well as radiological guidance. The channel is generally irrigated with fluid, either saline or distilled water, and that helps in clearing the vision as well as distending the ducts. And then subsequently, a biopsy forceps and lithotripsy probes, those can be passed and the procedures can be performed. So this is one of the videos by the manufacturer of this system. So basically, this is a single operator device. And so both the ERCP scope as well as SPI scope is handled by the same operator. This is plug and play, no assembly required in the endoscopy suite. And the reprocessing is reduced. It has two LED lamps at the tip and has a two dedicated channel for irrigation of the bile duct or pancreatic duct. And then we have a working channel. So through that guide wire can be passed or it can be aspirated, and the it can be connected to a Y connector and during when the wire is passed. It has four-way angulation, and most importantly, the both the wheels has got lock. So a scope tip can be locked in a particular position, which becomes very, very convenient to use. This scope can be passed into the bile duct either over a guide wire or directly, and we can have strictures examined and under direct vision. Here the spy scope is being passed directly, but most of the time we prefer it to pass over the guide wire, which is more convenient and to reach to the target site. And target site we can pass either lithotripsy or biopsy forceps and do the procedure. For better visualization and better targeting, we irrigate, which distends and clears the system. Similarly, it can be used in the pancreatic duct as well. So the passing of the spy scope over the guide wire is easier, safer, and prolongs the life of the scope if we want to reuse. The irrigation is necessary evil because it improves the vision, clears the debris, but it is also a soil for complication, particularly when we are working above a stricture. When there is cholangitis, it is always better to do the procedure after treating completely, because there are lots of pus flakes and also there can be flare up following the cholangioscopy. Complications are infrequent, rather occurs in approximately 2 to 10% of the patients in the form of cholangitis immobilia, rare bile leaks, or acute pancreatitis. Typical scenario where we require cholangioscopy is dominant stricture in the setting of primary sclerosing cholangitis, to distinguish between benign and malignant strictures. So this is spy legacy images. So this shows lots of nodules and polypoidal lesion, obviously malignant, but obviously you see the quality of image and the video of the legacy system was suboptimal. The findings which suggest malignancy is basically tumor vessel and the polypoidal lesions. And this system, even the legacy system, gave a good sensitivity and specificity for the diagnosis of malignancy in the bile duct and pancreatic duct. So pancreatoscopy also can be done using the spyglass system. This is mainly done either for lithotripsy or for the pancreatic tumor, mainly IPMN. So for the taking biopsy. So this is typical appearance of a IPMN lesion. So a scope has been passed and these are the sun. This is these are pancreatic stones which have been fragmented using the spyglass system and the lithotripsy probes. So that can also be used. This is a patient of pancreas division with a chronic pancreatitis, where we have used spyglass to pass through the minor papilla. And after passing the scope in the tail region, we can see there are multiple large stones which are white because of calcium deposition. So there are lots of limitations still with the spyglass system. Mainly it is the cost and fragility. The image quality is still suboptimal. It can be improved further. And the size of working channel also needs a little improvement. Sometimes because of inherent procedure related, there are some limitations. So I will like to summarize by saying that cholangioscope is an important tool in endoscopy suite. It has both diagnostic and therapeutic value. The instrument has improved over a period of time. Now the video quality is better, resolution is better, the accessories are also better. It has a good diagnostic and therapeutic yield in difficult situation where we don't have many alternatives available. However, fragility of equipment and the cost of equipment remains an issue.